Dynamics 365 Business Central provides a complete business application solution designed to and optimized for small and medium-sized businesses. Though the bulk of our efforts for the 2019 release wave 2 were focused under the hood, we did add a lot of great new capabilities. This video focuses on just a few of them. For the full list, visit our release plan. Cancel issued reminders and finance charge memos. Reminders and finance charge memos are usually created in batches. For example, at the end of the month, to remind customers about invoices that are due or overdue. If we spot a mistake, we can quickly correct and cancel issued reminders and finance charge memos. Let's go cancel a reminder. We'll choose sales, and then issue reminders, and then choose a reminder in the list. Now we'll choose actions, then cancel, and then OK. And that's all there is to canceling an issued reminder. The process is the same for issued finance charge memos. Copy line descriptions to general ledger entries when posting. When reconciling or auditing data such as expenses, it's often useful to be able to see the source document line descriptions on the general ledger entries. For example, the descriptions can include additional information about what is included in the general ledger entry. We can quickly copy line descriptions from documents to general ledger entries. Let's go copy a description. For this example, we've already enabled the copying capability on the Sales and Receivables Setup page by choosing Show More on the General Fast tab and then choosing the Copy Line Descriptions to GL Entry toggle. Now we'll open a purchase invoice. There are three lines on the invoice. One for April, one for May, and one for June. If we need to, we can change the descriptions for these lines before we copy them to general ledger entries. Now we'll post the invoice. On the Posted Purchase Invoice page, we'll choose Show More, then Action, and Navigate. On the Navigate page, we'll choose the line for the GL entry and then click on the number. The description fields now show the descriptions from the source documents, which gives accountants and auditors better insight into what the general ledger entries include. Copy documents, even when some lines are blocked. When using the Copy Document action to create new documents based on existing documents, we are now notified if any items or resources on the source document lines are blocked. The blocked document lines are excluded from the new document. The notification shows an overview of all document lines that are blocked in the source document. Let's copy a document. In this example, item 1920 Antwerp Conference Table is blocked. Now we'll create a new sales order for our ADATUM customer. We'll choose Prepare, Copy Document, and then choose the sales order we want to copy. The sales order we're copying contains the block item, so a notification displays to let us know that there's a problem. To find out what that is, we'll choose Details to see more information about the warning. The description field tells us what we need to know. Add links to the navigation menu. We've made it easier for you to shape the way you work in Business Central. In addition to the navigation tools we provide, you can now bookmark any page in Business Central and add the link to your role center. Let's explore this new capability. In this example, we'll search for a page that we often use but isn't already in our role center. We'll do that for the employees list. In the Tell Me field, we'll enter Employees. A link to the employees list page is at the top of the results. To add a link to our role center, we'll click the bookmark icon to the right of the search result. The link to the employees page is now added to the navigation menu on our role center. Let's close the Tell Me page and look at our role center. Resize columns with fewer clicks. Sometimes columns and tables contain data that is wider than the column, which means that we can't see all of the information. Resizing the column can help, which we can do on any list at any time. What's more, Business Central remembers our changes, so we'll see them on all our devices. Let's resize a column on the items list page. In the Tell Me field, we'll enter items. We can resize a column in two ways. We can drag the border of the column header until we get the width we want, or we can double-click the boundary between column headers, like in Excel, to auto-fit based on the contents. This can really help us visualize our data more effectively. Filtering option fields by multiple values. We can narrow down data to find certain records faster by using multiple values to filter option fields. The filter values we enter are treated as OR operations. For example, we can filter the color field by red, green, or blue. Let's go apply a few filter values. We'll use the employee list in this example. In the Tell Me field, we'll enter employees. We'll press Shift plus F3 to open the filter pane. Now let's look up an option field in the employee table. Now, if we don't know which fields are option fields, we can use page inspection to find out more about the page. To inspect the employees page, we'll press Ctrl Alt F1. To find the option fields, we'll choose the search icon and then type option. Let's use the first one in the list. We'll close page inspection and return to our filters. We'll choose filter and then enter gender. This gives us the values for that option field, which are female, male, and neutral. Let's use female. This will filter all records where gender is equal to female. We might want to use the filter some other time, so now we'll save it. Saving and personalizing list views. Defining the perfect set of filters can be a time-consuming, iterative process, so the ability to save our filtered views is very helpful. Let's go create a view for the employees page. We'll use some slightly more advanced filtering tools. In the Tell Me field, we'll enter employees. We'll press Shift plus F3 to bring up the filter pane. Let's use a date expression to filter on employees whose employment date is within the past 10 years. We'll type minus 10y for the last 10 years, then an ellipses, and then today. Now let's add all records where gender is equal to female. We'll type gender, choose the gender field, and then choose female. We can now save our filter, and it will be available the next time we need it, no matter how we access the page. Filter information in reports. As the business grows, so do the data sources that power its reports. This increases the need to control the amount of data that reports process. The filtering experience for reports has been improved with an experience much like filtering lists, which includes the ability to quickly add more fields, get assistance and validation feedback when specifying filter criteria, and applying expressions and filter tokens. Let's go apply a filter to the employee birthdays report. In the Tell Me field, we'll enter employee birthdays. Now let's find all records where the gender is equal to female. We'll type gender, choose the gender field, and then choose female. Let's use a date expression to filter on employees who were hired in the last 2 years. Powerful filtering capabilities, such as filter tokens, expression ranges, and filtering on multiple field values, gives us a faster, cleaner insight into our data, which makes us more productive in our jobs. Enhancement to Excel integration. Microsoft Excel continues to be one of the most popular productivity tools in business. For years, we've been able to use the add-in for Excel to export our data, view and edit it, and then import it again to Business Central. We've expanded our capabilities for working with data during the export-import process and made the integration to Excel accessible from more pages. For example, the filters we set on list pages in Business Central are kept when we export to Excel. Additionally, we have more fields that we can edit and publish to Business Central. The Edit in Excel action now also appears on the Lines section for several frequently used documents, including sales orders, sales invoices, sales quotes, purchase orders, purchase invoices, and purchase quotes. Let's explore these capabilities in Business Central. In the Tell Me field, we'll search for sales orders, and then choose sales orders in the search results. Now we'll open a sales order and choose a line on the order. To view it in Excel, we'll choose Page and then Edit in Excel. Excel opens and the worksheet contains the data from our sales order line. Now we can edit the data or use it for further analysis. Multitasking across multiple pages. During our busy work days, we're often doing several things at once, and we need to be able to allow for interruptions. To give us the flexibility we need, we can open pages in Business Central in new tabs or browser pages so that we can do all the things we need to, even if we need to work in more than one company. If we're working in multiple companies, the colorful company badge indicator helps us keep track of where we're working. Let's try it out. In the Tell Me field, let's search for sales orders, and then choose the Sales Orders link in the search results. On the sales order, on the navigation menu, we'll choose the Open This Page in New Windows action. The sales order page opens in a new browser page. If we change something on one page, the other page is immediately updated. Multitasking is a great capability that can help us get our work done faster. Explore the capabilities of Business Central. As a supplement to using the current Role Center navigation bar, the command bar, or Tell Me, the new Role Explorer makes it easy for us to find functionality by providing a full overview of pages in the product based on the content of various Role Centers. To open the Role Explorer on our Role Center, we'll choose the menu button at the top of the page. The Role Explorer lists all the capabilities that are available on our Role Center. To make specific capabilities easier to find, they're categorized. But if we need something else, or are just curious, we can choose the Explore All button to view a similar page for another role. Customize a user profile without writing code. Normally known as Profile Configuration Mode in the Dynamics NAV Windows client, the Business Central experience allows lightweight UI customizations for groups of users that share the same user profile. This can be done entirely without the use of Visual Studio Code and AL. In the Tell Me field, we'll search for Profile and then choose the Profiles Roles link in the search results. On the Profiles Roles page, we'll choose New. Now we'll enter a profile ID and a display name for our role. Next, we can let other people explore our new profile by choosing Show in Role Explorer. To start designing the capabilities of our new role, we'll choose the Customize Pages action. We can now design the look and feel for this specific role without writing any code. For example, we can hide an element, change the order of the navigation menu, close the customized view, go back to the Business Manager role page. Now we'll open the Role Explorer and see our personalized content. And we're done. We can now assign our role to other users.